Good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming out tonight. For those that don't know me, I'm Jim Nelson. I'm one of the volunteers here. And all the people that are working here are volunteers, so please give them a hand.
For those of you who've been here, you know this, but this is like probably the best listening room here in St. Louis. And so, and you'll, you know, this is the best place to see this kind of music. Tonight's band, I'm sure that most of you are here because you know who these people are, right? All right. So, for those that you don't know, you're in for a great evening of old-time country music.
Yeah.
That's the best way to describe it. There's a little bit of bluegrass, a little bit of fiddle music, old-time brother duets, hot banjo playing, mandolins. These guys, fiddling, great fiddling. Corrina Rose Logston and Jeremy Stevens. They've been playing together for several years. And they've come to be known as the Stevens Brothers. And that's probably, you know, it has something to do with the fact that they're very partial to the old-time brother duets. But I heard a story that they wanted to be brothers so bad that they got married. So if you'll put your hands together, I'm sure that Jeremy and Corrina will come out and entertain us.
Thank you, Jim.
Thank you, Jim.
When corn is ended and that bird had to lay down, what glory will then be mine?
Then be mine.
My robe will be spotless and I'll put on a bright crown. In heaven I'll shout and shine. Sorrow in that homeland of the soul, my spirit will never pine. I stand in a number and make sweet melodies roll. In heaven I'll shout and shine. Gonna shout,
gonna shout,
gonna shout,
gonna shine
in that city of love divine.
How often, oh, how often
gazed on the waving tide.
Thank you all very much. We're Jeremy and Corrina, the Stevens Brothers, and we're glad to be here with you at the Focal Point tonight. Going to switch instruments up here a little bit and get two guitars going here for you. We're doing some of our songs that folks like a good bit and starting out our set with those. We've got some different things tonight for you too as well.
How many of y'all were here the last time that we were at the Focal Point? Show of hands or clapping? All right. And you came back, you know? The last time we were here, Jeremy hit his head. And we didn't know how that show turned out. And we watched it later on. We said, that's just going to stand alone there. I know we've got a lot of interesting things planned for you, but we had to be able to bring the bar up to that show. It really stood alone for us. We thought, you know, that was really entertaining to us. So thank you for coming back, and we're glad to be here with no head injuries. But on that note,
at least none outside the norm.
That's right. Nothing that's out of the way of the norm. But on that note, we'll go ahead and do one that's been requested a whole lot for us to do, and it's one of our favorites called Highway 52.
Said, son, before you leave me, there's something I want you to do. Promise me that you won't go wrong as you travel down Highway 52. I'm sitting on the banks of the Ohio River as the sunrise kisses the dew, and the foxhounds run and the steam. I'm sitting on Highway 52. If you don't love me, and shoes for the last old run in that big black car as they haul me down Highway 52. As they haul me down Highway 52.
Thank you so much. We've sort of been living a little bit of that song. We came from Ohio just last night. We're going to go ahead and get Brother Jeremy here. You know, since we do go by the Stevens brothers, why, we can be friendly and call each other brothers. So over here, this is Brother Jeremy, and he's picking up the instrument of his choice over here. He's a multi-instrumentalist. Plays just about anything with strings on it, except for the concert zither. You know, folks say, is there anything he can't play? And I can't really be dishonest without feeling bad about something like that. So you got to tell the truth, and I hate to mention it, but I said, well...
I'm an aspiring concert zither player.
That's a good way to put
it. There you go.
I'll remember that, how to kind of put a little positivity into it. But everything else with strings, you'd think that he's just about a master on, including the piano. Hammers on the strings, you know. That's right.
Yes.
And we're going to get to see some of your other talents a little later on, Lord willing.
Lord willing, yes.
That's right. But he plays all sorts of things. He's won contests all over the place. He's a bluegrass banjo all-star. He's got his very own trading card as a banjo player. That's right. We don't know if he's a rookie or an MVP, but he's an MVP in our book, and he's going to play a good banjo tune here. Make him welcome, if you would, Brother Jeremy Stevens.
Well, I thought I was in tune.
That's okay. What is this one that we're doing, by the way?
John Hardy was a desperate little man.
All right.
Working your right hand on that one. I was
working
my own three fingers on that too. But anyhow, well, we'll tell you who this gal is over here. Brother over here. Brothers in the Lord. There you go. Well, I'm as proud of her as I can be. She is my much better half, and she's a wonderful singer, wonderful songwriter, wonderful multi-instrumentalist, as you're already seeing here this evening. And you'll get to hear some of her songwriting as the program goes on this evening as well. But she's played with a host of the most well-known pioneers in bluegrass music. Heard many years on the radio there on WSM Grand Ole Opry with Jesse McReynolds and his Virginia boys. Y'all make a welcome here this evening, Miss Corrina Rose Logston.
Thank you, Jeremy. That's brother Corrina to you. Well, we mentioned we were going through Ohio last night, you know, and every time we hit Cincinnati, Jeremy goes, oh boy, and I had YouTube queued up. I had it on that song that Connie Smith sang, Cincinnati, Ohio. I mean, as soon as we hit it, Cincinnati, Ohio, Jerry goes, here we go. Well, we had a little drive to do, and we got a little bit on a country music kick. And I got to listening to this this song that I've heard a lot of times Connie Smith sing, and I really enjoy her singing, and I enjoy doing a lot of the country songs like this. So I thought I'd try it here for you tonight, and gives Jeremy a chance to... I'm not trying to do a little dance for you. I have this kind of like a Rubik's Cube where you turn one side, you get something else. Yeah.
That's good.
I wrote that a little small. And you know, I think I know it, but I just like to make sure I've got it.
You sang the whole thing at sound check without no words.
I did?
I think you did.
You know what? And you can see what kind of things that we like to.
Yeah. In fact, we had some Topo Chico over here at the Mexican restaurant with Jim Dito.
If there's anyone from Topo Chico watching, we could do some nice jingles for you.
Yes, that's right.
Very delicious mineral waters.
Yes, indeed.
Anyway, I just thought I'd try this song here. And it's an old Connie Smith song. And I think Jeremy does just a great job playing the sort of steel guitar type banjo on it. And I'm going to look at this here if I can, because I'll get distracted listening to your pretty notes.
Oh, well, I appreciate that. I'm just going to give you a turnaround on this, and we'll figure out the break as we go along.
Okay, well, just be yourself and, you know, show out a little bit if you can.
We'll see what happens.
Okay, it's called Where's My Castle?
Once I cried because impatience let me down. I could see the gold before the gold was found. 'Cause every time I trusted love to lead me by the hand, it circled back and left me where I stand. Destiny, how much longer will I have to dream? Where is my sunshine? Where is my valley? Oh, where is the love that's meant for me? Next time I cross over that old bridge, I'm gonna stay. I don't care if the river washes it away. 'Cause I'm not gonna take another step until I find a man with a faithful heart and a made-up mind. How much longer will I have to dream? Where is my sunshine? Where is my valley? Oh, where is the love that's meant for me? Oh, where is the love that's meant for me?
Thank you so much. Well, Jeremy and I are also part of a bluegrass band called High Fidelity, and we enjoy... Oh, thank you! We enjoy doing some of the material in that band in duet form as well, and want to do this song that sort of talks about our love for the banjo. You know, I guess Jeremy and I met and bonded over many things, including bow-tie-type banjos. You see its little bow ties? Yeah. They're so cute. I like that one the best, I think.
Yes, that's nice.
And
I have one that has the block right here and an even smaller, cuter one at the bottom.
I remember
that. I didn't bring that one tonight.
I remember that one. Yes. It's very nice. But anyway, this song talks about, you know, when you want to be thinking about banjos, but, well, you just got a lot of other stuff that you got to do, and we enjoy doing it as a duet, as well as in our full band with High Fidelity. This one's called The Banjo Player's Blues.
When days are my bones are sore from working all day long, and nothing else can cheer me best than a good old banjo song. I got the mean old banjo blues, they're awful hard to lose. All day long, you know I sing this song called The Banjo Player's Blues. It's happy life to me. My heart goes bang when I hear the ring of a mountain melody. I got the mean old banjo blues, they're awful hard to lose. All day long, you know I sang this song called The Banjo Player's Blues.
Mentioned that we do some original material, and in terms of High Fidelity, group that we were talking about, we've never done a whole lot of original songs. We've always kind of dug up old gems from the past, and Jeremy and I like to feature quite a bit of variety, you know, some original songs, some old ones, and this year we put out an all-gospel album with High Fidelity, and we want to do a couple of those selections for you. Thank you. This one is actually kind of was rare for us because it was a song. It's got my name on it. I consider it a gift. The Lord gave it to me, and if I told you how it happened, you'd understand what I mean, because I woke up in the middle of the night with this song in my head, and I thought, boy, I could probably go back to sleep at that point in life. I wasn't sleeping much, and figured out later on what all the cause of that was, but I would wake up a lot. I wouldn't be able to go back to sleep. But I thought, boy, I bet I can go right back to sleep. Had that nice sleep feeling, you know, like right when your alarm's going to go off. You know what I'm talking about? But it was in the night. You know, I could still get a lot of hours. And had this little melody running through my head with these words. I thought, I better record this. So I got my phone out, hit record, and all these words just started coming to my head. I didn't really even have to think about anything. Just was singing it away. And well, directly, I heard somebody beside me. Well, it was Jeremy, of course, because we was laying there, and we're married and all, and here we are laying in bed, and he's just snoring away. Wasn't snoring, I don't guess, but he was sleeping away, and then I started hearing him singing with me, and I go, what are you doing? He goes, I'm singing, huh? I go, I'm writing a song. He goes, oh. You can hear this on the voice memo, too. It's funny. But long story short, I forgot about this. I went right back to sleep. I sang the whole thing in there, put my phone down, and went right back to sleep. Days went by. I mean, probably three good days. And I was cooking something, and this little melody came back in my head. I thought, I think I got a song the other night, and I played it back, and I said, there it is. And I said, boy, this could be a little high fidelity song. And I said, I can't believe I got this. Surely the Lord gave it to me, because I've always wanted to be able to write something that sounded like the Leuven Brothers or one of these brother type duets we sort of cherish the songs of. And I got this gospel song that kind of fit the bill, and we got very excited about it. And when it came time to record our gospel record with High Fidelity, everybody said, well, this is a shoe-in. We've got to record this. So I was very honored. It was our first single off that record, and it did very well, still doing very well on the gospel charts. So I want to do it for you tonight in its original format, which was this brother duet type style. And we got a little video on it with High Fidelity as well, so I hope you'll check that out. It's a very special song to me, and I guess autobiographical, because I was going through a lot of health problems when I got this, and shortly after that, everything started making sense, and I've definitely received a lot of physical and supernatural and spiritual healing, all sorts of things. So it's a song that talks about that and about the power in the name of Jesus. It's called The Mighty Name of Jesus.
Bring forth the healing, bring forth the victory, bring it forth for you and me in the mighty name of Jesus. Come forth healing, come forth victory, come forth for you and me in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Old Satan would have you afraid.
Call down power from Jesus.
For we have faith that's beat the grave.
In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Call forth your healing. Call forth the victory. Call it forth for you and me. In the mighty name of Jesus. We have this in jars of clay. Power given to us. Save. Call it forth as bright as day. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus.
He's freed us from our sin.
Just believe in Jesus.
But there's much more that we might win.
In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Bring forth the healing. Bring forth the victory. Bring it forth for you and me. In the mighty name of Jesus. Come forth healing. Come forth victory. Come forth for you and me. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Stripes are healing raised.
Call it forth through Jesus.
And be made whole like the leper who prays.
In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Call forth your healing. Call forth the victory. Call it forth for you and me. In the mighty name of Jesus. We have this in jars of clay. Power given to us. Save. Call it forth as bright as day. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Sing this song.
Sing the praise of Jesus.
You got the answer all along.
In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Bring forth the healing. Bring forth the victory. Bring it forth for you and me. In the mighty name of Jesus. Come forth healing. Come forth victory. Come forth for you and me. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Then we get to all right.
Who put that stool there?
Yeah. I'm going to use that in a little bit, and maybe I ought to go ahead and get it to my side over here so we don't have no accidents. All right.
You were going to say maybe I ought to go ahead and sit down.
Well, yeah. That's coming soon here. Anyhow, well, we're going to do another song off of our new gospel record with our band High Fidelity. Feature one that comes from the Bales Brothers, another brother duet team from back in the 1940s and 50s. They were quite popular on the Grand Ole Opry, especially in the 1940s. And good
Eddie
song.
Eddie Stubbs used to play this a lot on WSM.
Yeah, that's right. WSM radio went through a time where they're in it again. I guess they're embracing it now, but that they thought this was about 20 years ago. They kind of thought that they were going to be changing the format of WSM and going to like talk radio or something. And they haven't done talk radio now, but if you turn on WSM, it don't sound like it used to. We'll say that much. But anyhow, things change as we go through time in the world. But at that time, some of the disc jockeys, Andy Stubbs, of which was one, played this very regularly on WSM. Anyhow, a little bit different take on what the song's about, but interesting nevertheless. One called We're Living in the Last Days Now.
I've heard the wondrous story of the Christ of Calvary, how he died to save poor sinners deeply bound. He ascended back to heaven, but he said, I'll come again. We're living in the last days now. Oh, sinner, thou prayest forgiveness, my friend. Oh, that judgment day is surely coming round. Get ready for that city, John's soul coming down. We're living in the last days now. Just as they do today, we're living in the last days now. Oh, sinner, God prayest forgiveness, my friend. Oh, that judgment day is surely coming round. Get ready for that city, John's soul coming down. So true, the things that's taking place there can be found. No, you just can't get around it, for it's true, it comes from God. We're living in the last days now. Oh, sinner, God prayest forgiveness, my friend. Oh, that judgment day is surely coming round. Get ready for that city, John's soul coming down. We're living in the last days now. Get ready for that city, John's soul coming down. We're living in the last days now.
Ooh, thank you so much. Well, we're going to get Jeremy to pick up the banjo over there, and you know, we didn't get a chance to set up our records beforehand, but I've got a little fiddle album I did a few years back, and there's a lot of songs on there that, you know, you just kind of forget what you've done through the years, and you get used to playing one thing or another. And we were up near Washington, D.C. a few weeks ago, and a fella asked me about this song, and it is a song that I guess, became popular from the fiddle player Clark Kessinger. And I really have always enjoyed his playing. He's more associated with old time, but kind of had a drive like a bluegrass fiddle player. And so when I was getting songs together for my fiddle record a few years back now, I kind of dug back into the catalog, seeing what I could bring into the bluegrass world of things. And I think this one makes a really nice fiddle and banjo number, so we might see if we can get Jeremy to play a little break on it too. But it's one I want to do for you here tonight, and it's just, I like a lot of these cute sounding songs, you know.
Cute.
It is cute, though. It has a little high part in there.
It's, oh, yeah, that's right.
Gets that, real cute. But it also, cute, yeah. I mean, it's aggressive, too.
Yeah.
I guess I identify
it,
with
it
that.
It covers, yes, yeah, I reckon you do. Cute and fiery. All right.
Cute and, well, sometimes you just never know.
That's right. It's called Wilson's Hornpipe. Song here that get my banjo tuned down a little bit. This one was written by a dear friend of mine, a mentor of mine from Stuart, Virginia, a fellow by the name of Cecil Hall, and played with Cecil and his band for quite a few years. And Cecil had been good friends with Charlie Monroe and was sort of the last band that backed Charlie Monroe in his last years of performing there in the mid-1970s. And in Cecil's latter years, I played a good bit with him, and he wrote a lot of songs, and he gave me half writer credit on them. And then as he sort of waned it down in his playing, what are you laughing about here?
I'm not thinking about Cecil or anything. I was just trying to figure out how I was going to get myself out of this with this instrumentation.
Okay. All right. So, all right, I'm sorry. You got something going on your own there. Anyhow,
I just realized I wrote fiddling guitar for this.
Oh. I'll play guitar.
Oh, would That's you what, like
yeah,
to?
Yeah, I'll play the guitar here.
Okay.
Let me go ahead and take this. You grab your fiddle, and I'll hold both
I'm
of
so
them.
I'm so sorry.
And then I'll yak, and then I'll put them down.
Wait, can I help you?
No, you go ahead and get your fiddle.
Okay, well, I don't want you to miss talking about Cecil.
I'm going to talk about Cecil. Okay. All right. Anyway, I played with Cecil in his latter years, and then as he quit playing just a few years before he passed away, he had a publishing company, and he gave me his publishing company, and it's what I carry on today when I write a song, which I hadn't written one myself yet, but anyhow, I do have quite a few in the catalog. I do have a few banjo tunes in there, actually, but yeah. So, and if you have a song you'd like published, why, Dominion Valley Publishing can help you out as
That's
well.
Right.
But anyhow, all that to say, it was I wanted to carry on some of Cecil's legacy. Cecil called it ringing that bell. He said, I just want to get out there and ring that bell. So we're still trying to ring the bell for Cecil Hall, and grateful for all that Cecil did for me and down through the years and the great music we made together. So we would do this in the memory of Cecil. It was the first single off of my album that came out just a couple of years ago. And it's one called Could I Knock on Your Door?
Could I knock once to get on your door, to search for the love that I'm looking for? Losing you was a shame, though we both were to blame. Could I knock once to get on your door?
My love for you, I know will never die. Makes no difference what I do or how I try. My mind goes back to you again once more. Could I knock once again on your door?
Could I knock once again on your door? To search for the love that I'm looking for. Losing you was a shame, all we both were to blame. Could I knock once again on your door?
We're always together, it seems. We had plans for the future and our dreams. You were someone that a man could adore. Could I knock once again on your door?
Could I knock once again on your door? To search for the love that I'm looking for. Losing you was a shame, all we both were to blame. Could I knock once to get on your door? Could I knock once to get on your door? To search for the love ashamed of we both were to blame. Could I knock once to get on your door? Could I knock once to get on your door?
Need the prayers?
Okay.
Alrighty. We're going to do you another gospel song you'll find on our new album with High Fidelity here. And this one's an old one. It comes from old shape note songbooks going back to the early 1900s, but it made its way into bluegrass music. I guess first sort of in early country music by folks like the Delmore Brothers, and Don Reno and Red Smiley had a great recording of it they did in 1959, and they also used it as the theme song for their early morning gospel segment of television show before their well-known program called Top of the Morning, which you can still see some footage of on YouTube and places like that now. But A few folks remember Happy Valley Hymn Time, which was a 15-minute segment prior to Top of the Morning. You had to be up at 6:45 to see Happy Valley Hymn Time. And my mom and dad, this all happened in Roanoke, Virginia, and WDBJ television over there. And my mom and dad, as children growing up in that area, were familiar with Reno and Smiley from them being on TV, though they never liked bluegrass music much, but they do now. But anyhow, my dad's a Rolling Stones fan, and mom played piano in church, and wonderful history of old-time gospel music in my family there as well, my grandfather and such. Boy, I'm just really talking tonight. We're just going to sing you this song.
Well, we're
here.
Just so excited to be back.
That's right.
But no, this is a beautiful song, and it's just, I think it's got a lot of truth in it for what everybody needs, including us for sure. I need the prayers of those I love.
I need the prayers of those I love while traveling o'er life's rugged way, that I may true and faithful be and live for Jesus every day. I want my friends to pray for soul above and intercede with God for me. I need the prayers of those I love.
Much. Well, we have got a really special treat for you guys tonight. You know, we do a lot of traveling all over the place, and you know, we usually have our main instruments with us, but you know, this time we've been on a little East America tour. I think we started somewhere in North Carolina.
I'm gonna have you keep talking because I just realized I don't have the picks for that. I'm gonna have to go out to the car.
Oh, well, good luck. Good luck. All right. Anyway, we started in North Carolina, and we were working with this lady who was recording us an album of songs from the Carter family. Well, it just so happens that Jeremy is one of the premier students of that kind of music. I mean, very meticulous about knowing the different styles, like the Mother Maybelle guitar and knowing how to play the auto harp and all that. And so on this trip, we had a bass with us, an upright bass, this little archtop guitar, and, well, we carried an auto harp. And Jeremy said, well, I'd kind of like to do a little song on the auto harp tonight. And I said, well, that'd be just fine. Now, I didn't know you could really, I mean, I didn't know a lot about auto harps before I met Jeremy, but I didn't know you could really pick melodies and things like that. I'd only ever seen people kind of playing rhythm on it. Well, there's a technique to doing this, because even though it has auto in the name, you do have to do something with it. And I guess that auto refers to the fact that you push those bars down and it makes certain chords. But I think it's kind of like, you know, pedal steel guitar, them certain chords block out certain notes, and then certain other notes are open, and then it's kind of like, I don't know if you got to be half crazy to play it or what. Do you know, Jeremy?
I am half crazy.
Have you found your picks yet?
No, I don't know where they went, but I can think I can make do with these.
All right. I'm so sorry. Did you ever find that microphone we lost last night?
No.
Well, we've been all over the place, like I said. And, you know, sometimes there's some casualties. I'm glad we got some good insurance. But
well,
anyway.
The problem is I didn't put those picks back where they belong.
You didn't?
No, so I don't know where I put them. But
well,
we'll find them.
All right.
They're still here.
Yeah, they are. They're just not right where we are right now.
That's right.
That sounds good. Well, we've talked about the auto harp. I've told them about it.
Yes.
You see. And I notice you're making sure you get that microphone out nice and good for it.
Oh, yeah, it want it to be heard.
That's right. It just sounds like a little hillbilly angel up in heaven when he plays it. And I don't even know anything about these keys and such, but
well,
I think you're missing some papers on there.
Yeah, I'm missing some of them. Well, you see, and I was short a string, and we was late getting started here because I remembered I had that string missing, so I stuck a B string off a guitar on it.
Well, you're always resourceful.
Yeah, that's good.
Well, so what key do I play in?
I'm going to get you to play in the key of C.
Oh, well, that's nice.
Yeah, just like the label says right there.
Okay.
Boy, when you sit down with things, all kinds of things in your pocket get in the way. So, well, I'm going to do you a song here. Lord willing, if this thumb, this is for a banjo, but we're going to see how it works for the auto harp. This is an old tune that was made popular by Bill Monroe, and maybe it's original him. I don't know much about the history of this song, but it's one called Close By, and it was recorded on the auto harp by my favorite auto harp player, which is a guy from southwestern Virginia by the name of Kilby Snow. Now, Kilby Snow was left-handed, and he played the auto harp upside down like this and picked up with his finger and did all his melody picking. But in 2006, I was very privileged to go to Oxford, Pennsylvania, and meet his son, Jim Snow, who also played the auto harp right-handed. And he said, I can do all them drag notes just like Daddy did, but I pushed with my thumb where he pulled with his finger. So I saw him do that, and I thought, I just figured there was no way I would ever be able to play in the style of Kilby Snow. But it is possible, and it's a little bit different because of the accents. But we'll see how it works. I'm a little out of practice because did you tell them about that recording session? And
I did, but did you notice they kind of hoorahed when you said Kilby Snow? So you
yeah.
got some people
right.
that know about the auto harp here.
Have to be I hope his thumb pick worked out for me. Here we go. It's called Close By.
Thank you.
It's Jeremy Stevens on the auto harp.
Well, I spiked it. It was about half spun around, but there we go.
That's all right. Maybe if you're good for Christmas, you'll get a new thumb picking and stocking. We got a few months, so think about that. Anyway,
there you go.
No, that's enough talking for now. We're going to let y'all get up, stretch your legs a little bit, and take a little break. And maybe, did you need to find anything else? Or you good for now?
I've got a lot of looking to do when we get done with all this.
Well, we've been traveling nonstop for a few weeks, you know, and so yes, when you get some dirty laundry back there, you got to move things around. Sometimes right. They get swallowed, you know,
yes.
Things can disappear.
That's right.
So we're due to clean things out
yes.
a little bit.
We'll get it straightened out tomorrow before we leave again.
But you know, we're hot off the road for you.
There you go. This is a great Lilly Brothers song. We love singing this one. And as soon as we take a little break here, we'll get back and get the record set up, and y'all can come shake and have any visit a little bit with us.
Thank
and,
you guys for coming out here. We'll take yes. a little break. Thanks for being with us.
There's a right and a wrong way to press along, and the right way you must take. If you want a friend at the journey's end, out of debt on that great payday, never stop, oh, lest it be too late to inherit the golden crown. You must walk each day in the gospel way if your works of God be found. Of man giving gold that they might see, but in secret give and in secret pray, he'll reward you openly. Never stop, lest it be too late to inherit the golden crown. You must walk each day in the gospel way if your works of God be found. Conscience grown on tomorrow's dawn, should you meet him on the way. Never stop, oh, lest it be too late to inherit the golden crown. You must walk each day in the gospel way if your works of God be found.
Come visit with us. We'll be back in just a little bit.
Hello there. Welcome back. You guys. Don't mind them. And I just want to bring this up, too. On May 4th, there's going to be a fundraiser for the Focal Point. And just keep that on your calendars, and you'll be hearing more about that as we get closer. But anyway, how about if we just put our hands together and give these guys another round of applause, and they'll play a few more great songs and tunes for you.
Tomorrow, I ain't gonna work today.
That are older tunes, I guess you'd call them traditional songs, Ain't Gonna Work Tomorrow and The Old Turkey in the Straw. both songs that we have actually recorded with High Fidelity in the past, but they make good duet songs. And speaking of high fidelity, you know, when I was introducing Jeremy, I was telling you about all his talents and stuff. You know, he talked about all this work I've done with folks, and just thought I might mention to you that he's also worked with a host of pioneers in this music. When he was 16 years old, he worked with the Lilly Brothers, who were just staples in bluegrass music, and got to play all the banjo parts that were made famous by Don Stover, who's another legend in bluegrass music, and got to work with Jesse McReynolds right about the time that I started working with Jesse, and Bobby Osborne, and just you name it. He's worked with everybody from the Chuck Wagon Gang to Ray Stevens. And this is one that we got from our hero, Jesse McReynolds, when we were working with him on the Opry. And we wanted to do a song with him. And he had mentioned, well, anytime you want me to record with you, I'd love to. And, of course, that meant the world to us. And we got to do this song, which is one of their early records. It was an early Jim and Jesse Capitol recording that they never went back and re-recorded. A lot of these older artists would re-record their hits through the years. This was one that they actually never did another recording on until we got Jesse in there to work with us. This was another one we recorded with High Fidelity, and it is just a real pretty song, and we like to do it in tribute to Jesse. He sang a third verse on it, played a mandolin break on it, and are you going to do a little cross-picking on this, kind of emulate that?
I'll try to. I'm sort of working at that. I've never done this on the guitar before, so we'll see.
You know, we like some of that jack-in-the-box type surprise.
That's right. We'll just see what happens.
That's right. You know, that's always an entertaining... That's entertaining part that you bring to the show, my love.
Okay.
But anyway, it's one we like to remember Jesse with, and it's a beautiful Jim and Jesse type song called Tears of Regret.
Heartbroken and blue, I'd give all this world once more to see you. Each night my pillow from tears is all wet. I'm crying my heart out these tears of regret.
Tears of regret I'm shedding for you, though I know in my heart no good would it do. Tears that are falling won't make you return. Regret while alone I must yearn.
If you're ever lonely and think about me, remember my darling, no pleasure I'll see. I'll look to the future through tears of regret. I've lost you forever, but I'll not forget.
Tears of regret I'm shedding for you, though I know in my heart no good would it do. Tears that are falling won't make you return. Tears of regret while alone I must yearn.
I know.
Tears of regret I'm shedding for you, though I know in my heart no good would it do. Tears that are falling won't make you return. Tears of regret while alone I must yearn.
so much. Well, I guess I'll do a little original song here for you that I've been doing more here lately. And, you know, I was talking about being... Thank you.
You're welcome.
I was talking about, you know, being at my house and getting that Mighty Name of Jesus song. Well, come to find out, my house was part of the problem there. Had a toxic mold type problem. And it was real crazy. And, of course, we believed it. You know, we lived at the foot of a hill and everything. When all this stuff kind of came together, we said, well, this makes total sense. We got our testing back, and that made total sense. And, well, right before then, you know, I'd finally found a doctor who kind of was onto this type of thing. And he said, I think we need to test your house here to see if you got some mold, and we'll have to take it from there. He said, you get that fixed, and... Well, this stuff should clear up for you. And, you know, me and Jeremy, we looked at each other and, you know, if you ever kind of thought to yourself, well, I'll just fix this thing and it'll all be done. Well, it's like you'd have had to bulldoze it to fix it. I looked at my doctor. He looked at me and he looked at me and I looked at him and I said, well, the type of fix that we're talking about doing here, I'm not sure, might involve a bulldozer, but no, we ended up actually, I was thinking, well, what are we going to have to do if we need to do something different here? I thought, you know, it's not like I want to love this place so much that I'd want to, you know, put hundreds of thousands of dollars into it, which is a lot of times, you know, you get into this business with the mold type thing and finding out problems anyway. I was about to say, you know how it is, but it's because we talk about it all the time. But really, it's like that with a lot of stuff, right? You know, you get into something, you think, do I really want this? But I was praying about it, and one morning I just thought, man, what am I going to do? So, of course, I still wasn't sleeping, really, at the house. All that's changed now, so thank the Lord for that. But anyway, I got up one morning, and I just plain as day heard, I'd been thinking, Lord, what am I going to do? I just wish you'd just tell me what to do about all this business. And I still didn't know the answer, you know, with the house. And I heard, pack up your stuff because I'm sending you out. I mean, just plain as day. And I thought, is that you, Lord? And I heard, pack up your stuff. I'm sending you out. And contemplated on this for a while. Should have done it right away. It'd been a lot easier.
Would have been a lot easier if it had.
You know.
But, you know, you think, well, that maybe I just... We're leaving for a time. We're going to have to work done on the house or something. No, when you hear that, it's usually to the full degree.
That's right. So anyway, I was thinking about all this in the midst of it. Well, we started moving our things out. Long story short, I'll tell you about, you know, a lot of folks ask me when I tell this story. They say, well, what happened to your house and all, you know? We did a little remediation on it, and it still didn't work for me. And our neighbor, he was family property for him, and he was in construction. It wasn't no big deal for him to get in and fix that kind of thing. It all worked out real great, and we did real well on it, and he did well, and he's got it now, and he's happy. But, you know, for us, that wasn't the type of thing we wanted to get into. But anyway, talking about this house business, I started thinking, well, I wonder if I'm really supposed to pack up my stuff and get out of here. And I started thinking about all these people in the Bible that heard these things that might have sounded crazy if they repeated them to, you know, their neighbor at the grocery store or something. Like, you know, can you imagine Noah? He's at IGA and he's like runs into Carl. Hey, Carl. And Carl's like, hey, Noah, what's been going on? Noah's like, oh, you know, the Lord told me to build this big old boat because he says he's going to destroy the earth. You know, I'm going to build a great big old ark. And Carl's like, you know. And so I started thinking about all this stuff and how important it was, and people did what they were told. So I kind of put together all these different characters in the Bible and was thinking about it all. And my favorite thing in here, I mean, it's all, I like the Lord kind of give it all to me, like my name of Jesus. But I liked talking about Elijah because I didn't know about him until I read about him. But the Lord... He did a lot of things with him. He had him live in a cave for a while. And one of the things was he said, you know, Elijah, I'm going to send the birds to feed you. And can you imagine that one today, you know, on the news or something? So anyway, it's a long intro to tell you about this song, but it's a fun and encouraging song to me. It's one I just call Obey.
Noah feel this way when he was told to build a ship for sea. He didn't understand, but he obeyed. But he obeyed, but he obeyed. He didn't understand, but he obeyed. Did Elijah wonder if he'd heard that he would be fed from a bird? He was sustained by God's own word when he obeyed. When he obeyed, when he obeyed, he was sustained by God's own word when he obeyed. Oh, Jesus cried upon the hill, "My Father, if it be thy will, this cup remove from me, but still I will obey. I will obey, I will obey. This cup remove from me, but still I will obey." So if you're wondering what to do, don't be afraid of something new. Just trust and he will see you through when you obey. When you obey, when you obey, just trust and he will see you through when you obey.
Well, I believe Walter asked us about doing this one down there. So happy to have Walter and Willa Bowles out here. Give them a little hand there. Still out there promoting music against all the odds, and sure have appreciated you guys all through the years and still just love you, love you, love you. A lot of folks say, "Are you related to Willa?" And I'm not, but I would claim her. That they usually haven't seen my mom when they say that, but sometimes I see them both, they're like, "Who does she belong to?" But we'll do this one here for Walter. It's a country gentleman song, and Jeremy gets to show off some of that good mandolin cross picking. You heard him play a little on the guitar, but he does Jesse's type of picking, Jesse McReynolds type cross picking on this one. And this is a song I've always really enjoyed, and I like climbing things, you see. I haven't got to do a lot of that lately. We almost got to do some hiking. We did walk down to a waterfall the other day.
That's right.
I climbed up a little rock. But this talks about a little bit.
Yeah, this is pretty serious climbing on
that's
this
right.
One.
That's right. Yeah. Well, you'll see what I mean.
You got to go to Bern, Switzerland on this one.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. That might be a little higher than we've been here lately. But anyway, it's one called the Matterhorn.
We started out from Bern one sunny August morn. There was just the four of us against the Matterhorn.
There was Albert the Australian and John the Irishman,
me and Bill from Britain, mad dogs in the sun.
Matterhorn, Matterhorn, men have tried it, men have died to climb the Matterhorn, that mighty Matterhorn.
Miles up, we lost John and the rations fell below. Al and Bill were lying beneath an avalanche of snow. now here I am all alone, and I know I cannot stop. Two more yards in front of me before I reach the top. Matterhorn, Matterhorn. Men have tried and men have died to climb the Matterhorn, that mighty Matterhorn. Here I am a-dying upon the Matterhorn. Not a grave for me to lie in or a thing to keep me warm. The Queen would surely knight me if I could get back down, but it's closer here to heaven than it is back to the ground.
Matterhorn, Matterhorn. Tried and men have died to climb the Matterhorn,
that mighty Matterhorn, that mighty Matterhorn. Yeah. Woo! Thank y'all. Jeremy, I thought you were getting emotional on that.
No, it's just running my family.
It is a very touching song. I always have enjoyed the poetry of that. And, you know, Mel Tillis is a writer on that.
Right.
Didn't know that till we recorded it. Well, we'll get back to doing, I guess, what would be the... Oh, I see we skipped one on there. I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry.
I was excited about hearing you play the mandolin. Well, you want to still do this nice song about old mom and dad?
Let's go on to another one that features you. How about that?
Well, I don't really like doing that many about me in a row.
I like to hear you sing, though.
Well, Jeremy.
There you go. Look at
you're
that.
You're supposed to do Since When.
Oh, Since When.
Well,
Tales?
I mean, I was hoping we could bring it back.
Oh, I saw. I was skipping yet another one.
You,
okay.
Yeah. Well.
Okay. Well, we'll do this one then. That'd be good.
Do which one?
The Since When Bells.
Oh. Well, then I gotta...
Well, that features me, you see.
Well, I know. But then we gotta move... I got real proud of myself how I did that set. Are you gonna make me put down the guitar?
No, you play the guitar on this.
Okay,
that's
nice.
Like
that sounds like a good plan. Well, this is a song. Jeremy, he don't get to do this a lot. And a lot of times we'll put it on a set and, well, the time... kind of on the wall will start ticking and, well, it'll get cut or something.
That's right.
Or somebody will say, hey, Jeremy, how about you do that Don Reno song, this or that? And, well, he'll kind of say, okay, because he's just that tender-hearted, nice. He wants to make everybody happy, so we don't always get to do this song.
But I want to tell you about this one, because when I did my record, I had Ronnie Reno, which is Don Reno's son, guest on it. And I was very privileged, Don's other son, Don Wayne, loaned me his dad's banjo. So Don Reno's my favorite musician, following, you know, a lot of the things that he does and my picking and all. So I got to use Don's banjo. But not only that, I called Marty Stewart, and he loaned me Don Reno's guitar. And then I called Ronnie in, and he came, and he brought the mandolin that his dad had bought him, and Ronnie sang the lead. So Don Reno cut this with his son Ronnie in 1966. And those three instruments were on the original recording of it, and I got them on my recording of it too. So I
was. That's right.
And it was probably the first time in many years that those three instruments had been together again. So that was a real thrill for me. I like doing stuff like that. Every song on my album has a story behind it like that. So maybe
right.
Not quite as interesting with the instruments, but they all
this
got
stories. This one really takes the cake.
That's right. So anyhow, it's one called Since Wedding Bells Have Rung.
Since wedding bells have rung, my life seems empty. I bow my head, I'm unashamed to cry. I still can't realize you've wed another. Since wedding bells have rung, my dear, goodbye.
since wedding bells have rung, I hope you're happy. Make sacred all your precious vows, I pray. Don't break his heart as you broke mine, my darling. In closing, dear, here's all I have to say.
Since wedding bells have rung, my life seems empty. I still can't realize you've wed another. Since wedding bells have rung, my dear, goodbye.
Maybe I am laying here dreaming, and I'll awake and find that you're still mine.
Since wedding bells have rung, my life seems empty. I bow my head, I'm unashamed to cry. I still can't realize you've wed another. Since wedding bells have rung, my dear, goodbye.
Okay.
Well, we had a request for Jeremy to play this number, so we'll do just a little dab of it here for you. It's one called Saka.
Thank you. Well, we'll just do a few more here for you, and we'll have Corrina come around here and do the one that I thought we was about to do a little bit ago. This one's about some of the frustrations of living life day to day. We have all kinds of things sweeping up around the house and sitting at a stoplight and all those sorts of things. So.
Well, I know why you're having a hard time reading that set list down there, and why I did too.
Because it's on a Topo Chico box.
That's exactly right. I do. You knew that just like I did. I just figured that out. I mean, it's not every day that you read a set list off a Topo Chico box, and sometimes you get thirsty looking at it and everything else. So. Yeah.
I can see that yellow on the other side there. It makes me want me a good mineral water.
That's right. They're the best if anyone's out there listening.
That's right.
Can get
all
us...
you folks down in Monterey, Mexico, you just remember us. We like him, Topo Chico.
Stevens we'll Brothers support
right.
you. And not to exclude our friends at Evian.
That's right. still Vasa. All righty.
We'll do this for Willa down there. She likes this one, and I always like singing it too. I wrote it while I was sitting at a stoplight. It's one called Nevergreen.
Is this light ever green? Why is this light never green? No matter time of day, it never fails to make a scene. I'm only wanting to go straight, and it delays me. Tell me, why is this light never green? Is this road ever done? Why is this road never done? No matter time of day, they've got machinery to run. I'm getting tired of all the traffic jams and road signs. Tell me, why is this road never done? We spend the day wishing away that the world would be the way we'd like to see. Just let it ride, take it in stride, and it's never quite as bad as we believe. Is this house ever clean? Why is this house never clean? I can't remember when the cleaner-upper wasn't me. I've got my own lengthy to-do list I should tend to. Tell me, why is this house never clean? Bills ever change? Why do these bills never change? No matter what I do, the numbers will not rearrange. I try my best to save and put some back away. Tell me, do these bills ever change? We spend the day wishing away that the world be the way we'd like to see. Just let it ride, take it in stride, and it's never quite as bad as we believe. Is this light ever green? Why is this light never green? No matter time of day, it never fails to make a scene. I'm only wanting to go straight, and it delays me. Tell me, why is this light never green?
Trying to figure out how to get all the rest of this stuff in here. Would you want to do, I don't know. Here you go. Okay. We'll just do what we're planning on doing.
All right.
We'll do a little Lubin Brothers song for you here. Bring it back to home base here for the Stevens Brothers.
That's right. The mandolin and guitar and the duet singing.
That's right. We've done a little more banjo and fiddle playing on this one, but we like to keep you on your toes. So, while I'm thinking of it, what a great hand for everybody running sound here. It's just, I think it's Tom back there. Thank you so much. And we always have a great time always playing here because it always sounds so good. And big thanks to Jim and Dito for the fantastic supper and just getting us over here. And the focal point is a community effort. So give them a round of applause, everybody involved there.
Thank y'all so much.
That lay up their treasures on earth, though thieves can enter and rob. But the richest people at judgment will be the sons and daughters of God. The sons and daughters of God. Amen. The sons and daughters of God. The richest people at judgment will be the sons and daughters of God. Oh,
riches and joy everlasting await the sons and daughters of God. The sons and daughters of God. Amen. The sons and daughters of God. Great riches and joy everlasting await the sons and daughters of God.
Forgiven, I've been on my journey home. I'm riding on my Savior's train.
My Savior's train.
Jesus gives me transportation. I go home with Him to reign. I'm riding on my Savior's train. I'm riding on my Savior's train.
My Savior's train.
I'm homeward bound.
I'll be crowned.
When my train arrives in heaven, there with Christ will ever reign. I'm riding
on my Savior's train.
Simple pleasure and engage in song and prayer. Jesus came
to pay my fare.
Now I'm safely riding homeward full of Christ will ever reign. I'm riding
on my Savior's train.
Ticket who will leave all sin and shame.
Sing
one rise,
my Savior's train,
my Savior's train. Sinners, if you cannot rob this train, you are the one to blame. I'm riding
on my Savior's train.
Riding
on
my Savior's train.
My Savior's train.
I'm homeward
bound. And I'll be crowned. I'll be crowned.
When my train arrives on heaven, there with Christ will ever reign. I'm riding
on
my Savior's train.
All right, we're going to have Corrina sing another one that she wrote here, and then we'll do you an upbeat number and call it a night. We appreciate all of y'all coming out here. And
I just want to say it's a real special crowd of folks who come out on a Friday night.
That's
to
right.
Listen to this type of music, you know.
Yep.
What a lovely way to spend a Friday in Lent.
There you go. Oh, in Lent, I forgot.
Missing some fish sandwiches.
That's right. I was raised in a Baptist church and I forget about all those kind of things. All right.
Well, this is kind of an Easter-y type song.
That's right, it is.
It's this Sunday, I think, is Palm Sunday.
Yes, indeed.
And so this is a song kind of talks about this sort of thing, about the Lord being resurrected, and kind of was sort of my testimony and thinking about all these things talked about in the Bible and kind of trying to make sense of things. And well, just it's a song about the Lord, and got this at a hotel room in Daleville, Virginia. I like remembering where I get some
That's
of these
right.
songs. This was one of them, that melody started creeping in there. Well, I was awake this time.
There you go.
And so that's a little, that was, you know, that was, this was the first one of them type ones.
Yeah, there you go.
See, Lord was working me in, and
yeah.
Later on I got the ones I had to stay awake for.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go.
But anyway, we did a little video on this, and you know, I have this solo record that I've been talking about for like 4 years. And hopefully this year it's going to come out. And I got a whole bunch of songs that I've written on there, and kind of got some alternative type arrangements. So I hope you'll keep in touch with us. And, you know, you can keep up with us at our Stevens Brothers Facebook page. We don't have a website yet, but Corrina and Jeremy made that one. He put my name first.
Facebook.com/CorrinaJeremy.
There you go.
CorrinaS. Two R's, one for my mom and one for my dad.
That's Rockin' Rose.
That's right. I didn't know that till lately.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll do this little song for you. Song about the Lord called The Veil Has Been Lifted.
The veil has been lifted, it's torn in two. The veil has been lifted for you.
The veil has been lifted, it's torn in two. The veil has been lifted for you.
When on my own I'd wonder why God would permit his son to die. But when the Spirit came I knew it tore the veil for me and
torn in two. The veil has been lifted for you. The veil has been lifted, it's torn in two. The veil has been lifted for you.
Thank you so much. It's talking about how the veil of the temple was torn in two and Jesus died from top to bottom, symbolizing that, you know, that was like the holiest of holies. Oh, I was just gesturing. I talk with my hands.
I see. I should know that by now.
You do that too.
I do too, yes.
No, it was, you know, the holiest of holies was in there by that, behind that veil then. And Jesus died, then now we can all get to the Lord through him.
Full access to the throne.
And I just think that's beautiful. Well, we're going to end with a little upbeat song here. And sure appreciate, again, all y'all coming out. And if you want to check out any of our music, say howdy to us. We love talking to you. You can tell we enjoy talking. And we've had a lively time. So we're just, I guess that just beams on out of us.
That's right. We're going to leave you with this one written by our dear friend Bud Brewster. We got to visit with Bud the other day. He's 87 years old. He's been in the music business since he was about 12 or something, but way back into the 50s and over in Knoxville, Tennessee. Wonderful fellow. He wrote this when he was about 16, walking through a cornfield. And
then he wrote the last verse for us.
And I texted him one day. He's one of those older fellows that texts on his phone and knows all the technology and all that stuff.
We forget that he's an older fella because you feel like you're just talking to, yeah, you know, somebody. He puts K in everything.
That's right. Yeah, he says K, all that stuff. Yeah. It's really interesting.
Yeah.
And anyway, I said, Bud, do you? Is there a third verse to this song? And he said, no, but I'll write you one. And I said, wait, no, you don't have to do that. I just wonder, you know. And 8 minutes later, I got the third verse. I said, all right.
So he said we have to do that third verse then.
We sang it with him the other day, and he sang it. He didn't sing the third verse. I think he forgot he done wrote it already.
He's probably forgot more than most people
right.
have learned in the music industry. He's been around so much.
That's right. It's one called NC. Is it the first track on the new CD?
It is the first track on the High Fidelity.
On the new High Fidelity Gospel record, one called I'm Ready to Go.
Oh, that's me.
It's you. That's
right. It's a good ending song. I was just thinking about that. I'm ready to go.
That's right.
So I hope you enjoy it. I'm ready to go. How about you?
Many times I feel like shouting proudly on my Savior's name, for I know I find contentment and I'm holding to His hand. Someday I want to meet Him in that home beyond the blue. I'm ready to go. How about you? I'm ready to go, I'm going to pray. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time will end that day. Someday I want to meet Him in that home beyond the blue. I'm ready to go, how about you? If I'd kneel to Him, my sin would be forgiven. He told me if I'd watch and pray, my road would lead to heaven. I'm happy to say I'm on my way, and I know my Lord is true. I'm ready to go, how about you? I'm ready to go, I'm going to pray. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound in time will end that day. Someday I want to meet Him in that home beyond the blue. I'm ready to go, how about you? See the saints of old and the ones we hold dear, and standing there with outstretched arm, the one that's been so true. I'm ready to go, how about you? I'm ready to go, I'm going to pray. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time will end that day. Someday I want to meet Him in that home beyond the blue. I'm ready to go, how about you? I'm ready to go, how about you?
Thank you all so much. Y'all have a good night.
Thank you, Bugle Boy.
We'll do you a quick banjo and fiddle number if that sounds good to you.
Thank you.
We'll keep it up there where we were. This is one called, we got this on our duet record back there. Banjo and fiddle number one called The Buffalo Gal.